Hi, it's Katrina. From whale-sized beasts to dolphin-like lizards, here are 10 of the biggest sea reptiles to have ever lived. Number 10, Ophthalmosaurus. Ophthalmosauruses lived during the late Jurassic era, about 165 to 150 million years ago, and were present in oceans worldwide. Its name, which means eye lizard, comes from the fact that it had very large eyes, which you probably guessed. They were up to 9 inches in diameter. They looked particularly big compared to the size of the rest of its body. They grew to around 16 feet long and weighed up to 2 tons. This is the equivalent size to a beluga whale, but twice the weight. They had a large bony ring in their head that protected their eyes under pressure, and it's thought that this signifies that they hunted in the deeper parts of the ocean. Their increased ability to detect light would have allowed them to more easily see prey in the murky depths, where they would have hunted fish, squids, and mollusks. This would also have been an effective way to evade predators, because most other creatures of the time that were big enough to take on an Ophthalmosaurus wouldn't have wanted to follow them into such deep waters. Some remains have even been discovered with evidence of decompression sickness, which would only likely happen because of evasive tactics. It's not entirely clear why this species of ichthyosaur went extinct, but it's believed it was as a result of increased competition for food by other ocean animals, such as pliosaurs and plesiosaurs. Number 9. Platypterygius. Some of you helped me out the other day when I asked for advice with the pronunciation, so thank you! I'm finally going for it! The Platypterygius was a dolphin-like ichthyosaur that was around during the early Cretaceous period, about 100 million years ago. Growing up to 23 feet, they would have been the dominant predators of the Eromanga Sea in inland Australia where they lived.
They hunted fish, squid, and any other marine life they could catch, and had a number of adaptations to allow them to do so. They had long snouts with as many as 200 conical-shaped teeth. Their front and back paddle-shaped flippers were used to swim through the water, and they had dorsal and tail fins, just like modern-day sharks. Their front flippers had more digits than seen in other species of ichthyosaur, and it's this reason that they get their name, which means flat wing. Like other ichthyosaurs, they were air-breathing, and the remains of various subspecies have been found across Australia. We also know more about their reproduction than a lot of other species, because of some specimens that have been discovered. They give birth to live young, with the infants being about 6 feet long and ready to start hunting virtually straight away. Number 8. Thalattoarchon. The Thalattoarchon was one of the first ichthyosaurs and lived around 245 million years ago. Unlike others, their teeth were unusual. Rather than the conical shape, they were about 4 inches tall and blade-like with 2 cutting surfaces. Armed with such deadly weaponry, the Thalattoarchon is seen as the original oceanic macro predator, one that targets animals of a similar size to itself, as well as those that are smaller. They are the oldest known sea reptiles to have been apex predators in the seas, and were around just 5 million years after the Permian-Triassic extinction event, the deadliest such event to have ever happened, which was responsible for wiping out at least 96% of marine life.
There's only one known skeleton of a Thalattoarchon to have been found, and its surroundings give good evidence of why they were so well armed. The remains were dug up alongside other large ichthyosaurs, and it's been suggested that this species took advantage of their peers and would mainly prey on large marine reptiles.
Number 7. Plotosaurus. The Plotosaurus, whose name literally means swimmer lizard, lived around 70 million years ago in what is now California. They typically grew to around 30 feet long and were similar to other mosasaurs in that they had large, powerful tails for propulsion and narrow flippers, but were more streamlined than other species. Plotosaurus is thought to have been particularly fast and also had much larger eyes than others, which would have given them a huge advantage in spotting prey and predators. They were scaled and thought to be one of the last in the line of mosasaurs, seemingly much better adapted to swimming than their predecessors. They hunted fish, sharks, and smaller aquatic reptiles, but the lack of fossils that have been found means that no one's entirely sure what their teeth were like, or quite how deadly they were. Only a few specimens have been found, with some suggesting this species could have grown as big as 43 feet long in the right circumstances. Number 6. The Temnodontosaurus. The Temnodontosaurus was a species of ichthyosaur that lived during the early Jurassic, between 200 and 175 million years ago. They hunted for food in the deeper parts of the ocean, and remains have been found across Europe. Their name means cutting tooth lizard, and it's clear to see why. They were one of the largest species of ichthyosaur, but it was their robust teeth and deep jaw that enabled them to become an apex predator and eat fish, other ichthyosaurs, and cephalopods. They also had huge eyes, ones that were 8 inches in diameter and are thought to be the largest of any animal to have ever lived. Even so, due to their placement, the Temnodontosaurus would have had a blind spot directly above its head, which is where you'd want to hide if one of these beasts was chasing you. They were incredibly adept at maneuvering through the water, and their tails were able to bend to an angle of less than 35 degrees, which allowed them to quickly change direction and continue the chase. Number 5. Tylosaurus. The 45-foot-long Tylosaurus porringer swam the planet's oceans around 85 million years ago during the Cretaceous, while T-Rexes walked the land. It was a species of mosasaur and is believed to have been one of the deadliest oceanic hunters of the time, feeding on fish, birds, sharks, and other aquatic reptiles, you name it. They had two rows of cone-shaped teeth on each side of their mouths and a sensitive snout to smell out its prey. Two further rows of teeth on the roof of the mouth ensured that once the fearsome jaws closed on a target, there was no escape. They had long muscular tails to propel them through the water and paddle-like limbs to help steer. Most Tylosaurus remains have been found in Kansas, which used to be the site of the Western Interior Seaway, and shows evidence that the species died out at the same time as the dinosaurs. Number 4. Prognathodon. Prognathodons were huge mosasaurs that could grow up to 46 feet in length. They lived around 80 million years ago, and specimens have been found around the world, particularly in Europe and North America. Unlike other similar species, Prognathodon had a different way of hunting, adapted better for preying on tough-shelled animals like shellfish, ammonites, and turtles. For a long time, this diet was theorized based on its incredibly powerful jaw structure and its strong but serrated teeth that would have enabled it to break shells and tear up the flesh inside. Two specimens were found in Canada that had turtles and ammonites actually fossilized where the stomach would have been. Researchers also discovered traces of a long fish, which suggests that prognathodons were opportunistic with what they ate, as well as tracking down certain prey. Quite why the prognathodon went on this dietary direction, while other smaller mosasaurs became apex predators of reptiles and fish, is unclear. It's thought it could have been a result of increased competition for food during the period they were alive, and since shelled animals were not the most popular prey, it gave them a huge source to feed on that enabled them to sustain their large size. Number 3. Shonisaurus. The Shonisaurus lived towards the end of the Triassic period, around 215 million years ago, and evidence has been found of them swimming in the oceans around the world. Fun fact, 37 fossil specimens alone have been found in the Luning Formation of Nevada and is the official fossil of the state. They grew to about 49 feet in length, which is the same as two killer whales placed end to end, and they weighed about the same as a sperm whale, 30 tons. The Shonisaurus looked like an oversized dolphin, but the most surprising thing about this ichthyosaur is that it didn't have any teeth. The fossil record shows that when they were young, they did have teeth, but they would fall out as they got older because they simply didn't need them. Furthermore, they didn't have a dorsal or sail fin either, which meant that they wouldn't have been anywhere near as maneuverable as other similar animals. Still, their massive size meant that they probably wouldn't have had to worry about too many predators, and would have been able to get on with eating the huge amounts of soft fish and squid that they needed to survive. Number 2. Mosasaurus. The Mosasaurus is probably the most famous of the mosasaurs. If you think the name sounds familiar, it's the one that was kept in the lake in the Jurassic World movie. They were one of the last and one of the largest species of mosasaurs, and lived between 70 and 66 million years ago. Remains have been found in Europe and North America, but it's thought that they were present the whole world over. Researchers believe that the Mosasaurus lived close to the surface where it preyed upon fish, turtles, ammonites, birds, other mosasaurs, and plesiosaurs. They had large conical teeth that pointed backwards towards the throat, and their powerful tails provided all the propulsion they needed. These creatures would have been fearsome predators to everything else in the ocean, but that doesn't mean that they weren't preyed on themselves. Remains found in Canada have shown a half-eaten Mosasaurus, seemingly having been attacked by a group of prehistoric sharks. Number 1. Shastasaurus. The Shastasaurus was an ichthyosaur that lived in the Pacific Ocean during the late Triassic period, around 215 million years ago, and it was the largest marine reptile to have ever existed. They grew to around 60 feet long and weighed around 75 tons, which is a comparable size to a sperm whale and almost the same weight as a blue whale.
Their name means Mount Shasta lizard, after the mountain in California where they were first discovered. But the most interesting thing about the Shastasaurus was its unusual structure. Their tails were far less developed than other ichthyosaurs and arced downwards. Rather than being able to reach high speeds during a pursuit, it's more likely that they kept at a constant swimming speed and hunted opportunistically, catching any prey that crossed their path.
In a similar way to the Shonisaurus, Shastasaurus didn't have teeth either, not even when they were young. Researchers believe that this short, toothless snout means that it was a suction feeder and would only have eaten soft prey such as fish and squids.
Thanks for watching! Which one was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. Remember to subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Bye!